Hi, and welcome to the first lecture on shock. In this lecture, we're going to talk about shock, its pathophysiology, points to remember, and the types of shock. Shock is a life-threatening condition characterized by inadequate blood flow to the tissues and the cells. In this condition, since our blood serves as an oxygen conveyor, oxygen demands of the different tissues and cells of the body is not met, resulting in abnormal cellular metabolism. With decreased oxygenation, cellular hypoxia takes place. If not corrected, it would eventually lead to cellular death, and with cellular death, there would be organ dysfunction, organ failure, and later on, organ death. For better understanding about how abnormal cellular metabolism takes place during shock, let us first refresh our knowledge about how the cells work. Let us begin with adenosine triphosphate. Adenosine triphosphate, or ATP, is a chemical metabolically broken down from nutrients and stored in the form of energy in the mitochondria, or the powerhouse of the cell. ATPs are crucial in the cell's functions. Therefore, normal cellular processes are hampered in the absence of ATP, and ATP stores should constantly be replenished for the cells to work properly. There are three main ways as to how ATP aids the cells in performing its functions. First, it transports substances like sodium, potassium, and calcium through the cell membrane. Second, it synthesizes chemical compounds like cholesterol and protein. And third, it supplies energy for mechanical work like muscle contractions. Basically, ironically enough, ATP is needed to produce and reproduce more ATP. And this is done in two ways, either through aerobic metabolism, which is metabolism in the presence of oxygen, this is the more healthy way, or the other way, which is anaerobic metabolism, or the metabolism in the absence of oxygen, this is the less healthy way. In shock, because of the overwhelming demands of ATP, even though the body doesn't have enough oxygen, it resorts to an abnormal mechanism to suffice for the cell's metabolic needs. This process is called anaerobic metabolism, or metabolism in the absence of oxygen. Although anaerobic metabolism could produce ATP, it ends up with a negative byproduct, which is called lactic acid. As lactic acid builds up, it diffuses out of the cell membrane, going through the bloodstream and the muscles. This condition causes the production of ATP to slow down, thus decreasing the body's energy and performance. Adding up to that, lactic acid tends to inhibit the cell's ability to respond to nerve stimulation, thereby worsening the condition. To easily remember that processes of shock, always remember that shock affects all body systems if left untreated. Development may be rapid or slow depending on the underlying condition. The body's compensatory mechanism is triggered in response to the stress. In the case of shock, decrease in tissue perfusion is the stressor. Because of this, the affected person would manifest Salay's adaptation syndrome. If we could recall this syndrome, it starts with alarm response, wherein the body recognizes the stress, then progresses to resistance, in which the body resists the stressor, and then progresses to exhaustion, wherein the body finally succumbs, being exhausted, to the stressor. The stage of exhaustion could be prevented if ample treatment is initiated and the stress is alleviated. Shock is not a disease. It occurs as a result to an insult in the body that lessens the blood flow to certain areas. Since pathology denotes a condition produced by a disease, shock is not a pathological condition either. Shock's clinical signs and symptoms are not linked to its cause. It is related to the compensatory response of the body. Shock progresses in predictable sequence. Therefore, nursing care of a patient who is suffering from it would require ongoing sequential assessment as well as close collaboration with other members of the healthcare team.